Hello, hello everyone. Welcome back to my channel. Today we are doing a Kobo Libra color unboxing. If you are new to this channel, I review e-readers, mostly Kindles up until this point. I talk about books, I take you on little trips, and I do reading vlogs. So if that sounds good to you, make sure you subscribe and stick around. I just got this in the mail and the sun is setting, but I figured I had enough light to try and film a little unboxing. But if you notice some weird shadows, it's just because I really could not wait to open this. But I do have a lot of people who love unboxings who are subscribed to my channel, so I thought I would do like a little ASMR-ish unboxing so you could see what the Kobo Libra looks like. Maybe I'll start like the little setup process and then I will review it in a full review video in a couple of months once I've kind of had a chance to use it, and then I will also compare it to the Kindles that I have too, so you can really get a comparison if you're trying to decide which Kindle is for you. So let's first figure out how we're going to unbox this. I love when they're just a satisfying little pull. And you'll notice this is the white version. This was a big selling point for me, not only just the color of the actual, there are color covers and you can annotate in color, but the actual color of the device, the white one, because there are no white Kindles. It's so pretty. There it is. Got a little pull tab to get it open. Okay. It's got this texture on the back, got our power button, little logo. I actually kind of like this texture. I did order a cover for it, like just a plastic cover, but I might actually just leave it coverless because I kind of like the tactile feel of it on the back actually. All right, looks like also in the box, we have a quick start guide, which I will need because I've never had a Kobo before. Some other stuff, let's see. We've got a USB to USB-C, looks like charger. Cool. My other Kindles charge with USB-C too, or other Kindles. My Kindles, I guess. My other e-readers. Go ahead and put the box over here. Okay, so we've got this little pull tab for the screen. And we've got the page turn buttons right here telling me to turn it on. So I'm gonna flip it over, push the power button. There we go, it's starting up. Okay, we want English. Whoa, that was really responsive. Normally there's a little bit of a lag on my Kindle, so that was really fast. Okay, it says, welcome to Kobo. Let's begin by setting up your e-reader. Okay, so we'll get started on the Wi-Fi. Okay, it looks like it's downloading an update now that it's connected to the Wi-Fi. It seems pretty zippy, honestly. There's a little bit of like a distortion just through the camera. I don't know if you guys can see it. I'll have to wait till I upload this and edit it, but it seems almost like there's a little bit of distortion. I feel like my Kindles are usually pretty clear on camera, so that's kind of interesting. There's a little bit of a shadow there. Okay, we're still updating. This next to my Kindle Oasis, because these devices are pretty comparable since they do have like the side grip and the page turn buttons. They're pretty similar in size. Oh, here we go. Okay, so all it had me do there was just verify my Kobo account, and I just had to kind of scan that QR code and then confirm an email. So now it's telling me about Kobo Plus, which is their version of Kindle Unlimited. So it says, enjoy reading or listening as much as you want with plans starting at $7.99 per month, which is interesting because I think Kindle's is, I think I pay $11.99 a month, or around $11, and that does not include most audiobooks, although I saw a couple coming up, so I think they're trying to compete with Kobo. But here it looks like you have whatever's in their library, you can do whatever you would like for $7.99 per month. I don't know. If I start a free trial, will I have to pay for it later? I'm gonna just do that later. Okay, so I guess that was it. This is my home screen. So far, what I've noticed is these are like the screen is really responsive. It feels almost more like a phone screen, like the way that when I tap on something, it immediately just starts. And there's no lag, whereas I feel like when I touch my Kindle screen, there's a little bit of a lag. So it looks like this is our little home screen to find things to read, shop Kobo, top picks, browse Kobo Plus. I don't have any books yet on here. That's so funny. Let's just see what's on here. Okay, so I can do audiobooks too. So let's just see what we have. Okay, the color covers are really cool. I'm not gonna lie to you. That looks awesome. Best of the month. Ooh, Onyx Storm. I already have this pre-ordered, but let's see how this works. I think you probably just set up your credit card with it, and then I think I could buy it and pre-order right there. Cool. You can also have notebooks on here. I did not get the stylus yet, so I can't really explore this feature yet. But if I do get a stylus, then that'll be right there. It looks like you can group this by authors. I love that because sometimes I just want to see books by my favorite authors, and my Kindle can get a little cluttered. So I like the way that this sorts everything. Or series or collections. You can do collections on Kindle, but it doesn't really, the series function doesn't really function the way I want it to. Let's see what else we have on here. My wish list, my Dropbox, my Google Drive, my articles, activity. Ooh, I feel like I'm going to love this feature because it tells you all of your reading stats. That's really cool. How many hours of reading, average minutes per session of reading. Books finished. Oh my gosh, total hours of reading. If you are a stats person, I feel like this is a dream to get to see all of your reading stats. This is gonna like make me addicted to this device, I feel like, because the more I read on here, the more it will tell me about my stats. And I know it tells you like on the Kindle and stuff, you can see it at the bottom, but this is really cool just to see. So it did come out of the box with 49% battery already. Let's see what the energy saving settings are. Go to sleep after 5 minutes, automatically power off, show current read. Interesting. So you can put a pin on it if you want. Sleep and wake up. I don't have a sleep cover or anything right now. Okay. What else do we have in settings? How do we get to the settings? Do we pull down just like on a Kindle? What do we do? I guess you just access it from this menu here, and I think you can also drag your finger down the side to do that. Oh, okay, so that makes it warmer because I feel like I personally like to have it a little bit warmer. Natural light, bedtime. I'm gonna set bedtime to like 9 p.m. just because I liked it to be warm at that point. Do that. I think when you're reading, you can drag your hand down the side to do brightness, but since I don't have a book downloaded yet. So that's brightness, Wi-Fi, battery. This is like if you need to sync, and this is if you need to search. Okay. So one has Overdrive. I use Libby a lot, but I think I can connect. I really like how I have not used the quick start guide at all. I like how I just like started doing stuff. How many of you read the manual before you start doing things? Let me know in the comments, because I was gonna read this. Like, clearly I was like, oh, I'm gonna need this, but then I just started experimenting. So I'll have to read through that in a little bit. But just exploring the features, I just connected my library card. All I needed was my library card, and then I put in like the PIN that I set up when I got the library card. So it says I'm now set to start borrowing. This is pretty cool. Okay, so my holds. Oh, that's cool. So now it'll tell me like a funny story is available in 2 weeks, Hunt on Dark Waters, Not in Love, and The Paradise Problem are the ones that I have on hold from this library. I wonder, I probably can't connect more than one library card. Maybe I should connect a different one, because I have a couple of different library cards from the different places that I've lived, and this one you can't connect as many books, but I love that I can just see it right on here and not even have to go into the app. Let's see, new releases. Oh my gosh, here's Reckless. I actually just got this paper book in the mail, or I just got Reckless in the mail today, and I've already read it. So if you want to see my Reckless vlog, I'll link it down below. But I have my I read Powerless in a reading vlog and Reckless really recently. And I don't know, this is so interesting, because this one, I feel like I've heard other people say this, but now looking at this screen, I can definitely verify that I feel this way too. I don't feel as like pressured to buy books. Like, I feel like on my Kindle, there are so many. Here, I'll just show you. When you go into the library, there are so many books in here that it's like, it's kind of crazy. It's like there's so many suggestions. Like, so this is like my library, and then down here there are just like continue series you've started based on your reading, and I feel like it's really nice, but then I feel almost just like overwhelmed. Like on here I'm like, oh yeah, I wanted to read this, I wanted to read this, I wanted to read this. But then what was weird is on the Kobo I almost felt like, do I want to read any of these things? I don't know. Anyway, it's taking a second to load these covers. But let's see something that's like really colorful. I wonder if I can go in. Let's go back to my, I have this on my TBR, The Resort. Let's see. I think that's the right one. Oh, it's Sarah, this one. There's two Sarahs who have The Resort, and they're all thrillers. Wait, actually, that looks really good too. Okay, now, see, now I'm discovering things. Okay, so here we go. The Resort, how do I borrow this book? Oh, see, so instead of like buying it, it's taking me, like it's suggesting that I get it from the library first. That is fascinating. Let's see. Oh. Okay, so I didn't even have to buy it. It just was available from the library, so now it's mine. Wait, this is so cool. Okay, so here are all of my library books that I have checked out right now. Oh my gosh, okay, I love this. So do I download it like that? Start reading. I can either swipe or tap, okay. Look up a word, so same thing with Kindle, you can look up definitions, add annotations, read at night. Yeah, that's what I thought, where you can kind of like swipe up and down. We'll have to try that in a second. And it auto syncs, okay. I like that it tells you how to do that. This is so pretty. Oh my goodness. Is this the thumbnail for the video? It might be. That is gorgeous. Wow. Okay. I feel like the camera is not even doing it justice. That is so cool to see it in color. Oh my gosh. Because I feel like, let's see if I can just compare it for you. If I go over here, and I know I have a sample of this one. Let's see. There we go. So they'll open the sample so that way it'll become the cover over here. We can compare them a little bit. This is the Paperwhite Signature Edition. I know I showed you the Oasis, but this is the Paperwhite Signature Edition, just so you can kind of see size-wise and screen-wise. What's interesting is I do, my eyes are kind of like, they don't know how to feel about this. Like, this doesn't quite feel like e-ink with the color on it. I'm interested to see how it feels when I'm reading something, but this one definitely feels a little bit more crisp, a little easier on the eyes just immediately. Let's see. So that was the Kindle Paperwhite. Here's the Kindle Oasis, like I showed you earlier. Pretty much the same. I just love the white on this. How do they feel on the hand? I think they're about the same weight, I feel like. The Kobo might be actually a little bit lighter, but this one does have a case on it. And then here's my little, I call it my mini Kindle, but really it's just a regular Kindle. But oh, it is like the Kindle Basic, definitely a little smaller, but it also has a case on it. So there's kind of a little size comparison in case you already have a Kindle or you're trying to decide between them. That's just an initial size comparison for you. And then here it is. Here's just like a regular book. Oh. Here's just a regular book. You can see it's still considerably smaller than like a normal paperback and definitely a lot thinner. Ooh, it auto-rotates. I'm gonna have to figure out how to turn that off because I really don't think I want that. Interesting. Okay. I want it locked in portrait. Thank you for putting that up there. Jeez. Okay. Anyway, all right, so let's turn. So if I turn the pages, it is pretty snappy. Get through the front matter. Okay, it is pretty bright for my liking, so I'm gonna drag and turn this down a little bit. And then does this go back? Okay, so this one goes back and this one goes forward. Interesting. Okay. And then I think, where are the settings? Oh my gosh, how do we do this? Okay, here we go. There are the settings. So the settings are kind of on the bottom. So you can annotate brightness. I think this is changing the font. Okay, good. I was wondering about this, if we can change the font size. Oh, you can even change the line spacing. That's really cool. The margins, the justification. It tells you I started this book 4 minutes ago. The next chapter will take me 10 minutes to read based on my current speed. 7.7 hours to go. Some more settings, I think. Can I change this to say something different at the bottom? Okay, no, that's how you jump chapters. No, those are annotations. Okay, so I kind of think that's it. Like, you just have the page at the bottom. Okay, interesting. Prologue 1 of 7, 2 of 7. I'm assuming those are pages, and that's pages total. Interesting. Okay. If you're a stats person, this definitely might be a cool thing for you. Okay. So from this library, I have A Far Wilder Magic, The Djinn Waits 100 Years, The Priory of the Orange Tree, and The Naturals. I keep wanting to read all of these, but I have so many library books to read. And then the book I'm reading so far right now, which is the one you've seen from this Kindle cover. This one I'm reading right now in my Oasis, but it's from a different library from when I lived somewhere else because that library card has not expired. So I'm just taking advantage of that. But this is from a different library. I wish it was on here so I could just continue to read it, but it is not. I'll have to see if I can add anything else. But it's really cool that you can just see your library books right on here. So my first impressions of the Kobo Libra color is that it is really surreal to see the color covers. It's really satisfying. Let's see how much the battery has gone down. It's so funny that it says battery okay, but there is no stylus, so that's kind of funny. It's gone down 2% in the time we've been looking at it, which isn't terrible, but I feel like things always drain really fast just right when you get them. So, okay, now it's kind of getting like related reads. So I think the more I read, the more the algorithm will kind of know what I like. But I loved that I was fully prepared to just buy a book so we could see it on here. And instead of having me buy the book, the first thing it suggested for me to do was actually just borrow it from the library, and it happened to be available, and now we have it just right now. So I thought that was really cool. It felt a lot less pressure-y. I've heard that term used before for like the Kindle, where it like you have to really buy the book and there's no option to get it from your Kindle or to your Kindle from the library unless you already know how to use the app and transfer it over. And it's just not as seamless. Like, you can't do it from the Kindle device. Whereas here, part of my library books, like, it's just so built in. So I really like that integration a lot. I like the color. I like the feel of this. I like the feel of it in my hand. And I do think, yeah, it flips. So if you want to hold it in the left hand, you can. I don't think I'll put a pop socket on this. It really doesn't feel like it needs it. The Paperwhite, I do have the option to put a pop socket on. I actually have like a little stand and a pop socket for it. It's right here. I'll show you. If I wanted to, I have like little magnetic rings that I have stuck to the back of my Paperwhite. So this could just go right on the back here. And then this like either attaches or detaches if I want it or I don't want it. And it also becomes this like little stand. So if you are interested, this would work on your Kobo or your Kindle, whatever e-reader you have. Sometimes I forget where the little stand opens. But let me show you how this works in case you're somebody who wants this. I'll link all these down below in case you want to put this on yours. So I have the little magnetic ring thing. You have to get different pieces to make this work. I saw it on TikTok, but it was so expensive, and you can just buy the pieces from Amazon by yourself and just make it. So there's this little magnetic ring that makes it kind of MagSafe almost. Then you just pop this little stand on, and then this goes in the middle. But the cool part is that then you can like stand it up. So I could do this with my Kobo if I wanted to, and then honestly just use the same pop socket. Like, I only have one for all of my Kindles because I just rotate whichever one I'm using, because you can just use the pop socket when you want to, or you can pull it off and put it on a different device. Or I put this on my phone too because it's MagSafe, and then you can just attach and detach whenever you want. So I'll link all of that below. Again, I don't think I'm gonna use one for this one, although I could just stick one on the back and just see how it works. Here, how do I turn the screen off so I don't mess things up? Ooh, cute. I like how it says sleeping. Well, maybe I don't, because maybe I just want the regular screen. Weird. I wonder if you have to have that. I'll have to look at the settings. But if I wanted to, I could stick this little magnetic ring right on the back, and then I would be able to use this pop socket and have it stand up and everything. But I kind of like the hand grip just the way it is. So I will do a more in-depth comparison of the Kobo with all of my Kindles, and I'll do like a little update on whether I like it or not and which device I would prefer if I could only buy a Kindle or a Kobo, since they kind of have some different features. So if you're interested in kind of getting that update, make sure you subscribe, and I'll also make sure I use this in some upcoming vlogs so you can see it in action. So please give this video a thumbs up if you liked watching this unboxing and setup, and leave any questions you have in the comments, or any tips or tricks, or anything that you would like to see, anything you're wondering about the Kobo. I'm gonna link the exact Kobo that I got in the description as well as all my Kindles. So if you're interested in buying that, or checking out all these devices, they'll be linked in the description. So again, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.